There's a bunch of baddies in here. Ice Blight, two defenders, and a shield wall. And we're almost seen. Fire! Unfortunately. She's laughing. We got a bottleneck going on here. Reach. Trying to get through. Damn it.
What?
She can't get out. Damn it. I should have advanced farther. Ranged weapons are never as effective. But we have Aloth.
Eh? Yeah.
Defender, huh? You could be defending much for long. Let's see what we got. Just standard stuff. Not even fine weapons, just standard.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Any trap over here, Durance? Are you close enough, Durance?
I'm ready. I'm ready.
You're ready? Go over there. A diamond. And a note. Letter to Zoltan. Esteemed Coinmaster Zoltan, I write to you in anger and bafflement. Have I not been a faithful customer to you? Have I not been fair in my dealings? Yet after all of our business together, your people turned me away like some filthy beggar. I arrived at the battery a fortnight ago, frost in my beard, and not a morsel in my belly. Barely had I unhitched the horses when your commandant Exandru came to meet me. The priest told me that I would be made welcome, but my profane business would not. In short, I would have to leave at first light, my wagons empty. Certain that this was but a negotiating tactic, I told Exandru that I would of course see him compensated along with you. He left in a huff, and when I presented myself at the door, it was Commandant Maroon, your arms warden, who met me. She told me to leave at once, that she wouldn't have my coin-grubbing hands tarnishing Durgan Steel. Now, I appreciate forceful bargaining as much as any man of coin, but I was cold, hungry, and put off by her vehemence. So I showed her the letter you had sent me inviting me to examine your latest stock of Durgan steel. Commandant Maroon drove a rapier through the letter and sliced it in two. She then warned that her blade, a fine weapon indeed, would be the last I ever laid eyes on if I did not hie back from the mountain at once. Never have I endured such humiliation and expense only to return home empty-handed. I do not understand what has passed between you and your associates, but I urge you to take charge. I fear the other commandants will be your undoing, indeed that of all Durgan's battery, if you do not deal with them swiftly and decisively. Yours, Mestre Aneto of Cesaro. I wonder if this little event had anything to do with the downfall of Durgan's battery. Anything else in this chamber? There's a big chest. Wouldn't be surprised if it's trapped.
What?
It's not. Okay, a stiletto. Potion of Barring Death's Door. I'll give that to, I guess, our priest. Scroll of Hailstorm. And a copy of Daily Affirmations of Focus and Efficiency, which I've read before, way back when. There's another chest. Huh. Only 3 snow caps and 2 spirits. Nothing much in that one. This is that door that closed by itself.
Get out! Out!
I'm opening the door to leave. My, my. The war room? That goes... Oh, okay, through here. Hello, warish people.
Damn you both! My generation built this keep to honor Abaddon, not to further your greed and ambition.
We're Pergrunan. Our forefathers explored and conquered, but you've stuck us in this frigid hall.
Paved with gold and marble! I won't allow us to abandon our legacy for your delusions!
No, you'll peddle it away to line your pockets. How much have you made selling our steel, Zoltan?
Again with your lies. You think I don't hear you turning the others against me? These walls echo and...
Enough! I'll send the Forge Guardians on both of you if that's what it takes.
Hmm. That's pretty interesting.
My eyes are peeled.
A ring of unshackling. We have one of those. A scroll of stag's horn. Conjures an enormous stag horn to attack the target, causing pierce damage and inflicting a penalty to deflection and reflex. 30 to 55 pierce versus deflection. Minus 10 deflection, minus 10 reflex for 10 seconds. Hmm. Interesting. Any baddies in here with us? And let us all gather around so we can find traps.
A simple test.
No traps. Boots of stability and 25 cogwheels. Plus 30 defense against prone attacks. Plus 15 defense against push attacks.
No problem.
Oh. I'm not gonna use that. Not that it's not useful. It's just there's so many other boots that are better. You think you glimpse flickers of movement in this tarnished, clouded mirror. Ah, it's spooky. A fine arquebus and 3 bottles of oil. Again, flickers of movement. Let's see what kind of war documents they have. Scroll of Wall of Flame, one of us has that. Yeah. Just stack that there. Record of Production. Here is a current accounting of this month's production. 20 longswords, 15 axes, 12 hammers, 7 flaces. Flaces! 7 maces, 2 flails. 7 suits of armor for Forge Guardians, 3 additional suits of armor. If the Commandant's remark on production rates, kindly remind them that we received 3 different work orders from them. Vassal, Master Smith of Durgan's Battery. A note in another hand is written at the bottom of the page. What does Exandra need with so many Forge Guardians? Keep an eye on him. M. Must be a maroon. tempted to stop here, but it looks like, except for this door, we're almost done exploring this floor. Oh, I like how that relief went in first. Saw that? Before the door opened? I love little things like that. Here's a box. With spirits. I don't know why I pick up this stuff. Why not? There's a battery shield wall type person. Gonna be a big battery battle. He's pretty messed up. Knock down that one. Ooh, a wraith. We can't knock them down, but I can attack them. Some chain lightning. And let's knock down everyone we can anyway. As soon as some of us get up. Dare can knock this down. She laying down, Devil of Karak?
What?
So she laying down. Yeah, trying to have Aelath kill some things.
Eh?
Kill that shade. It keeps running all over the frickin' place.
How may I help?
Wait, you're killing the wraith? Okay. Wait, where is he? Alright. Everyone attack that. I don't think that works. I disengaged them. Trying to have him actually kill something. The wraith is almost dead. Kill the wraith. Everyone's not laying down. Adair killed the shade. Okay, everyone attack the battery priest except for Aelath, who will kill the wraith. Aelath killed the wraith, yay. How damaged is this priest? He has one. Everyone else run off. Let Aelath kill it. Good. Killed two more in one battle. bunch of junk. But we will sell it nonetheless. As usual, I'll have to open it twice to see it. 25 enemies. We have... what? 11 left? No. 12 left. Good, then we'll see one of these things level up. It'll be great.
Eyes open.
More stuff to loot. Hidden stuff, too.
Something over there!
Is this trap durance?
What?
It says it's trapped. No, it's not. Mantle of the Dying Boar. 2 lockpicks. Plus 5 endurance while endurance is below 33% per second. Plus will while endurance. Okay, I'm gonna keep that. A scroll of hailstorm. Get it. There.
Now this I haven't seen before.
Most of these crates and barrels are empty and several are overturned. It looks as if they were cleared out in a hurry. Bill of sale. You unroll the scroll and see an inventory of weapons and armor. Swords, shields, breastplates, and helms. All are listed as sold to a Lucan of Dunreed. The bill is signed by Commandant Zoltan, Coin Master of Durgan's Battery. What's going on with this Zoltan guy? Zoltan.
Fine.
Make the Z symbol. That's gonna open that, obviously.
He's a traitor to the battery.
Who that? Zoltan? Scroll of Restore Critical Stamina and Scroll of Revival. Ooh. Who's got the lore required? Critical stamina. Actually, I don't want to see people's lore. I have to go this way. Requires lore of 6. Okay, so Theodas can use it. Aloth can definitely use it, although he's the one who's usually dead first. Lore of 0. Okay, we're giving that to Theodas. I have to remember she has this. So she can revive somebody. It's 2 hands. Oh, okay. Got this one too. Alright, let's open this. Okay, so this isn't any special chamber. That was the war room.
You gotta see this.
She found something. Where is it? Oh.
If you say so.
Fine leather armor, potion of deleterious alacrity of motion, potion of iron skin. Aloth uses that once in a while, and 50 cogwheels. That's a person in the ice. Encased within a thick sheet of ice, this dwarven corpse has been remarkably preserved, though his features are obscured by the frost. Clutched in the dwarf's hands is a large cloth-wrapped bundle, perhaps a pack. Try to pull the satchel away. I know it won't work. You scrabble at the ice, but don't get very far using your bare hands. The satchel is as wholly encased as the dwarf holding it. The dwarf gazes blindly downwards, frozen in the moment of his death. Hold a torch to the ice. You set your torch beside the frozen figure. By slow degrees, the ice around the dwarf's hands begins to melt, though the water occasionally threatens to douse your torch. In time, enough ice falls away that you are able to reach the satchel. Well, if this guy's still alive, he could be, cryogenically preserved in suspended animation or something. Tug it open. The contents of the satchel are largely unharmed. You find a handful of stamped coins, some papers, and a scroll, along with a heavy iron key. Further searching uncovers nothing else. Okay, so we've got 150 copper, a scroll of Restore Major Endurance, and a rolled parchment. That's critical. That's major. Okay. So that's the only one we have of that. Requires 8 lore, though. Does anyone even have 8 lore? 7. Yeah, Aloth. Okay, in case Aloth needs to heal anybody, I guess. Oh, right, that parchment. Maroon's getting suspicious. I've got her sniffing after Zoltan for the time being, but she'll keep an eye on me. I had the lads put the last shipment in with the coal in a cart across the tracks. I'm counting on you to make sure it gets topside. You don't mind getting your hands dirty, right, Gregor? Oh, maybe Gregor's the real culprit behind this stuff.
Time to see and not be seen.
Okay. We're a little hurt, so let's camp. Stairs. And this door. So we're gonna go to this door. My general rule of thumb is all doors first.
Well, first. She'll bring these walls down around us.
Yeah, maybe. They're almost down already. Yeah, my general rule of thumb, if anyone actually even cares, is first I explore all open areas, then I go around open doors and look through them, and then I go up to different levels.
I'll keep an eye out.
As you approach the doorway, a wave of essence ripples through the air. The ancient stones grind and groan around you, and a woman's voice echoes from the hall.
Stop right there. You must be some merchant come to speak with Zoltan.
There's a pause in which the woman's wrathful essence gathers like a storm cloud on the other side of the door. The entire room creaks from the pressure of her presence. Palagina says, "It isn't enough we have to deal with angry spirits in this place. Now we have to talk down a paranoid door." I gotta say that's the funniest thing Palagina has ever said.
Our illustrious coin master may let you plunder our armory, but I've got other ideas for dealing with your lot.
Her voice is sharp and loud, like the slamming of a door. Fitting. As her words echo in the chamber, the ghosts startle and flinch, glancing about in agitation. Oh, they're gonna attack us.
Turn and go before I show you how an arms warden deals with trespassers.
Who are you?
I'm Maroon, proud Pargrin and arms warden of Durgan's battery. And you're answering my questions now.
Stone grinds and crumbles at the sound of her voice. Well, yet I'm going to ask you another question. What's going on here?
Pargrun and quarrels are no business of yours, outsider.
Her tone is as cold as the icy halls around you. A group called the Leaden Key is seeking something here. The ghosts stir, looking around and shivering. Their eyes widen and glow as they light on you, as if they're noticing you for the first time. Just as quickly, they gaze away and seem to forget you once more. But now they seem alert, wary.
Whoever you're searching for, I haven't seen them. And none get past me. Leave our halls. Go back to whatever land you hail from.
A draft moans through the bottom of the door. Your halls are full of corpses. I need to know how you died.
You waste your breath on hollow threats.
She didn't like that. There's a hiss, a grating noise, and a click of something sliding into place on the other side of the door.
I'll have you carved by Durgan steel, wretch. Then we'll see what the other commandants have to say.
Here we go. The ghosts turn their heads and lock eyes with you, shrieking and howling. The price of your sacrilege. Fragment of Maroon says. There's also a bitter spirit, and a specter, and another bitter spirit, and a wraith. Well, Aeloth is right there. Okay, start hitting it. See if we can get Aeloth over here. Weakening blow. This might be the toughest one. I don't even know. I gotta wait for combat to start, then he can cast that. Let's have these two wait and see what comes. Okay. I told you to back off. Maybe it won't attack him. I'm hoping the Spectre won't. I mean, they're not that dangerous anymore. Chain Lightning. I think it's fighting Theoness, so yeah. It is. Okay, so she did that. Let's see if I can blind it. Deathbolt of whatever. Killing Bolt. Nina Goth's Killing Bolt. he didn't cast that yet.
How bad?
He killed it! Did he? Aeloth killed a fragment of Maroon. Awesome. Now I guess hit the Spectre. Everyone can hit this, and he'll hit the Spectre. When did this happen? We've got a good Spectre. I don't know when that happened.
Right here.
Aeloth killed the Spectre. Awesome. I don't know who brought that in. Someone conjured it. I think it's an effect of a weapon. Now I'm wondering what weapon. Okay, we've killed all your challengers. What next? Grants Beetle Shell, Nature's Mark.
I'll keep an eye out.
Reveal your secrets.
Now this I haven't seen before.
So it just opens. Huh. It's interesting. Let's hope you can deactivate this. There's no way around it. Good. Don't close it. What time?
Got it.
Wait. How many different ways do you open? Oh, it stairs up. Or stairs down. Guess we're gonna go down. The mines. That goes up somewhere. Guess we're going down to the mines, because we're right here. So, we will do that next episode. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.